What is up, guys? The LA Gamer here, and today I am bringing you guys episode 1 of a new series on my channel. This is going to be Road to the Show on MLB 16, the show. So here we go. We're going to create a new player here. As you can tell, it's my first Road to the Show, as you saw the tutorials coming up right there. I think I've played Road to the Show long enough to understand what's going to happen, so I'm not worried about the tutorial. But we're going to use the current roster. I did just actually do a fantasy draft, and if you guys have not already, check that out. But what I said in that one is this game like basically just came out, so there's no rosters that have been created yet. So there's really no purpose in using a custom roster, because there's no custom rosters to be chosen from. So our option is either MLB, so we can kind of model ourselves after a MLB player who's already in the league, or we can just kind of customly create ourselves. So I say we just customly create ourselves. I've tried to do the MLB builds before, and it just kind of makes me uncomfortable, because I feel like you're not really being authentic, an authentic player, because they literally make it so you copy their hotspots, you copy their swing, you copy their, you know, the where they wear their the stuff on their sleeves and stuff like that. It almost just feels like you're just kind of mimicking them, and just kind of weird to me. I'm not a huge fan of it. So either way, I put a lot of consideration into what position I wanted to be. And the big decision came down to third base. Now, my reasoning for doing this is there's a huge new feature this year. I think it's called Showtime. And basically, that feature applies to throwing the ball. And you don't really have the chance to throw the ball around the infield and stuff, if you're playing in the outfield. And I had to consider first base, second base, shortstop. First basemen don't really do anything interesting in the field. All you do is run to the bag, basically, and catch the ball. And that's not really interesting. I don't really want to show you guys that. Second base isn't super entertaining, so basically the decision came down to shortstop or third base. My ultimate decision of why I chose third base over shortstop is because it would make more sense for me to be a slugging third baseman than it would for me to be a slugging shortstop. And my idea this year is to have a lot of power in my bat. I kind of want to be like a, I don't know, maybe like an A-Rod. I of course don't want to use steroids. I don't really think that's an option in this game regardless, but I do want to have a lot of power in my bat. I still want to have a bit of speed. Of course, A-Rod actually did once have a 40 and 40 season in his third or fourth season in the league. So I could just be kind of copying a young A-Rod in this creation. So we'll actually see what's going on here. We start off with 5 flex points. And I do honestly believe the most value or the most strategic way to use these flex points is to spend all of them in speed. My reasoning for saying this is because speed costs a lot of money. But if you spend all of them in speed, you start off with 90 speed. You're already a dominant speedster then if you use all your points on speed. If you use all your points on power, your power will go up maybe 10, 15 points. But that only costs like 1,000 skill points. Upgrading speed costs so much more. So that's kind of my strategic way of doing that. And then I'm also going to spend one on power. So that's my strategy there, because I want to be a power slash speed guy. I am kind of cheesing the system here by putting it all into speed, but it's the most strategic way to go. So I just think that's kind of what I want to do. So speed is going to be the way to go. I'm not going to necessarily be a speedster, but I'm going to work on my power as much as possible, and hopefully have a lot of power, have a lot of speed, and kind of mix it up. Now, I am from the West in real life, of course. For those who don't know, LA Gamer represents the Los Angeles Gamer. So I live in the western side of the United States, so that's where I'm going to be representing. I should have came up with the name prior to this, but I haven't yet. So this happens every year, actually. Every year I always come up with the name at the last second. So I kind of like the name Drake. I'll be Drake. It's unbelievable how tough it is to actually think of a name all on the spot. You guys wouldn't understand this. Drake, I always do like Harrison or something. But yeah, you know, I'm not creative enough. So Drake Harrison. I do kind of like that name. So we will go with it. Let's find it somewhere. Where is it? Are you telling me Drake's not an option? Interesting. Oddly enough, I have actually always liked the name Harrison for a boy. So we won't be Harrison, but we'll be Harrison Barnes. No, it would be Harrison Adams. There we go. Simple as that. And now let's go over, because I want to actually have my name be pronounced when I'm up going up to bat and stuff. So I can't be really choosing a name that isn't in the game. And Adams has to be in the game. So Harrison Adams, age will be 18. Strategically, don't you want to be as young as possible? I feel like that's kind of the obvious decision. So we'll be 18. Our preferred number, I'll be number 5. I feel like that's a slugger number. It's kind of Albert Pujols. You just kind of slug the ball. I feel like, yeah, that's a slugger number. I don't really want a secondary position. I feel like third base is where I belong. I'll put shortstop as a secondary position. But I'm obviously going to be a little bit more of a third baseman. My heart will be at third base. Birthplace will be California. That is where I'm from. I'm not finished, right? There's more to it. Or do you just kind of go step by step? Am I not allowed to change what I look like? No. Interesting. This is going kind of oddly quick. I wasn't even really able to change. Oh, I went to general. I didn't go to appearance. Okay, so yeah, that's my bad. So I'm gonna kind of measure out to how I am in real life. I am 6'3" in real life. So that'll be my height, and it's a pretty good height for a third baseman too, I'd have to assume. Pounds, I'm not 210 pounds, I haven't really filled out, but I feel like that's a good weight, which kind of be a normal size. Or you know, if I'm trying to be a slugger, let's be buff, let's be a little bit bigger. I don't want to be fat, I just want to be buff. Neck size, we'll just kind of have a medium neck size. Pants style, this has been a thing of mine. I played baseball for about 9 years. Even my first day playing baseball, nobody recommended this to me, nobody said to me. I always wore the high socks, it was just what I did. So I always have carried that trend over to MLB The Show. So we're gonna have the turtleneck. I'm self-conscious about the neck. I want to keep the neck concealed. So facially, some of these faces are just very, very weird. Not really digging a lot of this. I might have to actually put some extensive work into this face, because I'm kind of getting disturbed here. So we'll go like this. I'm gonna kind of go quick, as you guys can tell. Let's go like hair. Oh, you can change where your hairline is. Interesting. I can make myself LeBron and just yeah. I'm gonna go LeBron hairline and just, where is it? Yeah, I'll just throw it all the way back there. Now, let's go like this. Okay. Okay, yeah, no, I feel like that's a pretty accurate face shape now. Oh god, look at that hair. No, that's kind of how my hair looks right now. I typically put my hair up, but I feel like when you're playing baseball, it's kind of hard to keep your hair up, wouldn't it be? I mean, whenever I play baseball, my hair would just completely die within my hat, so I feel like the most realistic hair for me would be about there. I'm not really trying to make my guy look like me, though. I don't really feel like this looks much like me, but you see, I don't want sideburns. I do want kind of a beard like this, though. It's gonna be stubble. My idea is, I'm only 18 years old, so it'd be weird for me to have a full beard. But hopefully, I can turn this into a full beard. Let's say about a couple years into this, I'll try to make my guy have a full beard. Gonna have to be working on it, though. That's a lot of That's a lot of work. I just grow the patchiest stuff ever in my personal life, so I couldn't even imagine having a full beard at 18. Either way, let's continue. Eyebrows, these are some bushy ass eyebrows you're giving me to choose from. We'll go with this. I don't really want miscolorations between my eyebrows and my normal hair, so we'll go with that. My nose, this nose is alright. This guy does kind of have a weird looking face from the side, I'll be honest. There's kind of, it's the back of his head does kind of seem a little bit too big. Let me fix that real quick. It's kind of bothering me now. No, okay, not that part. The dome shape. I feel like it just looks better. He's got kind of a small face, so having the huge back of the head, it just looks like he's got like his brain's blown out or something. It's just weird looking. I don't like it. Oh, holy shit. you will hear everything on the field. You will literally hear, you can hear a hummingbird from 3 miles away with these ears. I don't want that. That's horrible. Okay. We're gonna get rid of that. Oh god, you can make this guy look really funny, and I'm really holding myself back here because I am so tempted. Ever since I made those ears, it's not acceptable. That's really bad. Oh my god, you can do some weird shit. Okay, you know what? Yeah, you can change personality. Okay, yeah, I got a bit carried away. I don't know why I thought personality, it would choose whether I'm like charismatic or something. Okay, yeah, but you have different running styles. This appears to be a little bit more upright. This is a little bit, this just looks like you hit a home run, you're just jogging around the bases. Okay, I'm gonna pick what looks like my running style most. I take really long strides being a tall person. I feel like this would probably match that best. Now we got this is actually a really big deal, is the batting stance. So let's see, what do I want to go with here? I'm very picky about batting stances. I really am. There's a lot of weird ones. But this is honestly what I used to look like when I was batting, now that I think about it. So I am kind of making this guy look a lot like me, unintentionally. It's a pretty cool home run celebration. I want to look like as much of a dick as possible when I hit a home run, though. I wish they could give you Jose Bautista a home run where you just flip the bat. You know what I'm talking about? I wish that was a possibility. But I feel like everyone would choose that if it was. This one looks like you stare at the ball for a long time. I kind of like that. Oh, this one's got a little bit of a bat flip, though. Yep, it's got the bat flip. Okay, we're going with that, then. I'm not going to go with any walk-up music, because although I want to, for the risk of copyright purposes, I can't really just... I just can't put the music in there. I just don't like to risk it, so... I don't know what my team colors are going to be, but since I'm wearing red... I'm going to be switching this probably when I get drafted. You know, let's not even worry about it then. We're going to worry about all this colors and stuff. We'll worry about it once we're actually drafted. For now, we're just going to go with stuff that actually matters. Like, okay, this is how I want my helmet to look. How about hat? Where's the cap brim? I don't like normal. I like semi-flat. I feel like flat it looks like you just don't give a fuck. And that's not really me. But semi-flat feels like you're in a mix. You kind of mixed looking cool and not being too dorky with it. So semi-flat is what I want to do. Eyewear. Are they really asking me? Okay, when I'm batting. Oh, I thought they were asking me if I wanted to wear my helmet out to the field. I thought that was what was going on there. And that would be the most disgusting thing ever. Could you honestly imagine somebody who wore their helmet while they were fielding? Because they were like, they didn't want to get injured or something. I would cry. I honestly would cry. I want to use eyewear. Why can't I choose? Why do I have to randomize it? I can't choose my eyewear. Okay, I guess we're not having any eyewear to begin with, at least, because apparently I don't know if I haven't unlocked eyewear or something, but I mean, why do I have to randomize the cleats? Okay, I don't know, guys. Oh, those look pretty cool too. These look pretty nice. Okay, we're going with this. This is kind of a longer creation process than I was hoping it would be, but I think that's what I want my guy to look like. My scouting report, of course. We're gonna look at this real quick. Oh, I'd have to attend the scout day to look at that. Never mind. We will see tomorrow, or not tomorrow. What am I saying? In the next episode, we will see how the scout day is going to go, how the whole scouting process is going to go, and hopefully I'll get drafted. That'll probably be all in the next episode. So that is it for this first episode. That's it for the creation. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, please click the like button below. Make sure to comment your opinion on this series and what I could do to make it more interesting in the comment section below. Also comment what you think about this player, what you think about this idea, this series, what you think I can do to make it more interesting. Of course, when I start a new series, I want to hear all your guys' ideas. I'm going to put all of them into consideration, so just make sure to comment them all down below. And lastly, subscribe if you have not already to stay tuned to this series and other series I got going on my channel, and that's really all there is to it. And yeah, that's all it. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time, and peace out.